Hi, my name is Manuel Alikani. I am the Dean and Professor of Orthodontics at CTOR Academy. I'd like to welcome you to another session of CTOR channel. The topic of today is the continuation of discussion of couple. If you remember from the previous discussion, couple of two forces that have parallel line of action, opposite in direction, but equal magnitude. This would cause a pure rotation around the center of resistance of the tooth without causing the displacement of center of resistance. However, application of a couple in the clinical setup seems difficult. How we can apply a force at the level of the crown, buccally, and how we can apply a force at the level of the root, palatally. We have access to the crown, but we don't have access to the root. However, if you remember from the previous discussion, there is certain characteristic for the couple that allow us to apply the couple at the level of the crown and achieve the same result. Let's go over those principles. If you look at this example, we have a force at the buccal at the level of the crown and a force at the level of the root. One of the characteristics of the couple that we discussed in the last session was we can move the force along the line of action and produce the same couple. So let's move the force that was at the level of the root, align the line of action and toward buccal side. Now, both forces are in the same side of the tooth. That made the application of couple a little bit simpler. Now, if you remember also, another characteristic of the couple was that the forces, they don't need to be in opposite side of the center of resistance. They can be on the same side of the center of resistance. So let's move the force that we just moved to the buccal closer to the force that we are applying at the level of the crown. Now both forces are in the same side of the center of resistance, but the distance between the forces decreased significantly. Again, if you remember from the characteristic of the couple, if we are decreasing the distance between the forces, to compensate for this decrease, we should increase the magnitude of the force. So let's do that. Now, we were able to compensate for the distance. Another characteristic of the couple was that we can rotate the couple in any dimensions that we want and create the same result. Let's rotate our couple in a space. And now if we apply this couple at the level of the crown, we can produce a moment and produce the pure rotation. We have access to the crown and we can apply a couple at the level of the crown. That's how the design of the bracket was started. You have a slot at the level of the crown when we can apply a couple. To be able to produce such a couple in such a slot, we, in this dimension of course, we need a rectangular wire. If we put a rectangular wire in this slot that we call it bracket, we can produce forces at the corner, and those forces can produce a couple and rotate the tooth for us. But we just don't want to rotate the tooth in this dimension. Let's see how many dimensions we have and how we can rotate the tooth in each one of those dimensions. In general, in orthodontics, we want to move the tooth in all three dimensions. The first dimension, the occlusal view, we call it first order view, requires a couple in that dimension, first order couple. The second view is that we are looking at the tooth from the buccal side and we are rotating the tooth in that dimension. It's called second order view, and therefore we need the second order couple. In the third view, we are doing a buccolingual cross-section of the tooth. We call it third order view, and the couple that is applied in that dimension is called third order couple. The example that I started this discussion today was a representative of third order view, when a rectangular wire was able to produce a couple that could rotate the tooth in that dimension. Now, if you look at all the dimensions, you can see that the couple is actually can be applied in all dimensions, not just only the third order view. We have two type of wires in orthodontics. round wire and rectangular wire. Can round wire and rectangular wire in a slot of the bracket that is rectangular produce all three types of couples? So if you have a rectangular wire, you can produce a couple in all three dimensions. Let's look at the round wire. Can round wire produce couple in the first order view? Yes, it seems there is not that much difference between the round wire and rectangular wire in producing a couple in the first order view. It can rotate inside the bracket and touch the corner where the ligature ties or self-ligating, if you have the cap of the self-ligating, touch the wire, and we have a first order view. Can round wire produce a second order view? Yes, the round wire, similar to the rectangular wire, can rotate inside the bracket and produce a second order couple. However, can round wire produce a third order couple? If you put the round wire inside the slot that is rectangular, the wire can touch the opposite surfaces, but cannot produce a couple. Let's look at this problem a little bit more carefully. If the wire is undersized, means it cannot fill the slot, it may touch only one surface, like the right side of this screen, or it can touch two adjacent surfaces, like the middle picture, or it can touch the two opposing surfaces. However, now you can say, well, there is two opposite forces, they should be producing a couple, but in the definition of the couple, we said that the line of actions of the forces should be parallel to each other. Here, the line of actions are the same. Therefore, the forces cancel each other and there is no moment in the system. Remember, for the couple, the line of actions should not be coincide. They should be parallel but separate from each other. So, round wire, even if the touching two opposite surfaces, cannot produce a couple. How about undersized rectangular wire? Undersized rectangular wire also cannot produce a couple in the third dimension if they are only touching one surface or two adjacent surfaces. When we having two adjacent surfaces, the line of actions are not parallel. Therefore, it is not a couple. Understanding the principles of couples help us to design a proper brackets. If you're having a bigger slot, you can apply bigger size wires. Therefore, we can produce larger forces and produce a bigger moments. On the other hand, if we have a smaller slot size, we need to apply smaller size wire, producing a smaller size forces and therefore less moment. We can also increase the depth of the bracket, but increasing the depth of the bracket, unfortunately, is not very comfortable for the patient. The principle of the couple not only can help us in deciding what should be the slot size of the bracket, it also can guide us to select our bracket wisely. Should we use narrower bracket that are more cosmetic, or should we use wider bracket? Which one of them you think it is easier to make couple? As you can see in this picture, if you have a wider size bracket, because the distance between the forces are more, it is much easier to produce a couple than if you had a smaller size bracket, where the distance between the forces are decreased, and therefore, the moment of the couple is smaller. Now, if you want to compensate for this lack of proper width of the bracket, you need to increase your forces. But how much you can increase your forces without breaking the bonding of the brackets? This problem not only exists in the second order view, also exists in the first order view. Of course, the wider the bracket, it's easier to rotate the tooth in the first order view. On the other hand, the narrower the bracket, the distance between the couples is shorter, therefore the magnitude of the moment that you can produce with the bracket is smaller and rotation in this dimension become more difficult. So, couple is a fundamental tool that we use in orthodontics. By proper design of the bracket and wise selection of wires, we can apply the couple in all three dimensions. Thank you for listening to another session of CTOR channel. I hope you enjoyed it. The topic for the next session is type of tooth movements. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel. And also, if you have a comment or question, don't forget to post. I will respond to them. Thank you.